Hi Matthew.
Yo yo.
So what's Daddy making tonight?
Beer.
Yeah, what kind of beer? Is it a lager?
Lager!
Well, it's going to be a Munich Helles lager.
Yeah.
Yeah. What does Daddy love, Matthew? Matthew, what does Daddy love?
Beer.
Yes. He loves the beer. We've got the mash water on, haven't we, Matthew? Heat it up. And then, while that's happening, Daddy's just going to take you to bed and read your stories.
No.
Yeah, you're going to go to bed.
No.
What's this one up to? Jessica! Hi. Daddy making lager tonight. He's going to make a Munich Helles.
Beer.
Is that Daddy's favourite?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like water.
You like water. Do you like beer?
No.
Not yet?
I need to be bigger.
Yeah, you need to get bigger. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, bigger.
Yeah, bigger.
Wow.
Like Daddy's belly. That one?
Yeah, I got a bag one.
You got a bag. Right, we're gonna go to bed, okay?
No.
See you tonight.
Good night.
I'm gonna read stories.
No.
What story are we gonna read?
My pony.
My little pony?
Yeah.
Oh no. Not again.
Yeah.
Yo, so I've just plugged in all my values into Beersmith. I was originally planning on doing a step mash from some of the guys' advice on Facebook, but then I also did a lot of reading up and some other people were saying just do a single infusion. So, and then I found a review, a comparison on the two methods, and it says basically there was no difference, no one could tell the difference. So I'm just going to do a single infusion mash. And that was at 66 degrees, so I'm going to do that. So I've just plugged it all into Beersmith. Just plugged it all into Beersmith, and it's given me my strike temperature is 72.4. So I'll do that. So the malts I've got crisp light Munich malt, 300 grams. I've got an Irish lager malt that I thought I'd try from Getter Brewed, so that's 3.6 kilos. And then I've got a dextrin malt as well, so I've got 200 grams of that. So that's plan. Hopefully that's a nice quick, because it's Sunday night, and then I've got work tomorrow, so something nice and quite a good night. That was 2 litres of water added extra, I didn't get it backed in, it cold, so it's now sitting at 66, so I'll get this wrapped up and get the sponge water on.
I should give you an update on my New England IPA because I haven't really done any kind of grain to glass or anything like that. So, go find it that.
Right, this is a Keezer and this is a New England that we did last time. We're almost there. Right, anyway, as I said, New England IPA. It was pure mental when I first kegged it. It was like way too juicy. But it's been 2 or 3 weeks now it's been in the keg. And it's calmed right down and it's very drinkable now. But I think it's overly bitter. It's not bitter, but it's like kind of get that, what they say when you whirlpool. Very tangy, almost tangy zest finish to it, which isn't very much. It's not sessionable, but it's good as a one-off. It's nice. So after that one, I brewed the Beavertown Neck Oil Clone, and that's very, very sessionable. That's super easy to drink, and that's now in, so I can now drink that as well as this. So I imagine the neck oil will go first, and then this will probably overlap with this lager. The Helles. So, yeah. Cheers.
At the bottom. So that's all hooked up. Pipes, and that's where you're going. And yeah. That's actually really good. Oh. sticky if it was already. I don't have a clue what this is meant to be, but I thought I'd just have a wee splash. N20? Fuck. N20? So, I have just measured the wet grains and it came to 2 kilos. And it should be 4.1 dry, so that's why it was a tiny bit. That's semi-decent size, but nah, it was. So I've checked my order, it's definitely ordered. It was like 3.6 kilos of lager malt, so. Aye, oh well. Getabrew didn't send the right amount, but I should have cross-checked it before I started, just because I had kind of doubt. I was like, that's strange, because normally it comes in the big bag. I've got so much tidying up to do and nothing to show for it now. Rotten. Right, to be continued. Okay, should be up. Okay, so this is now a couple of weeks later, and the grain was definitely wrong, and it's now been, a new bag's been sent out, and I'm now brewing with it, so yeah, another day, I'm just got on it. I'll show you what's happened so far. I'm just currently just mashing in. I've got another 15 minutes, I think 5 minutes I'll get the boil off going again, and I'm just getting my sparge water up to temperature as well. So yeah, and other news, I've got a new fermenter, stainless steel by Anvil. This is my birthday present, early birthday present. But yeah, so brewing with this is pretty cool. Because what you can do is you can turn the tap basically, and what it does inside is it turns the wee spigot pickup, so then you can actually pick up above the tub. Yeah, so the good thing with that is you don't need a racking cane, so that's cool. That's ball off going anyway, so she's circulating away quite happily, and I'm just getting the sparge water a wee top up actually, but hopefully this one goes a lot better than the last one. Boom! Should do. I need to put the fermentation fridge on actually. Get that starting chilling. So we'll do that now. Right, here she is. The fermentation fridge. And get on. Donk! Double check, that's it. It's full of water, I was just testing it. I was testing my setup. They'd actually up drilling a hole. You see that? Drill a hole into the freezer because it just wasn't being rapid enough. So that's what I did. But she's ready. Okay, so first runs are in. And I'm just batch sparging and just doing a boil off and that just to make sure it's nice and clear. So I'm about to probably just chuck it in there and we'll get the boil on. Looking good. Measured pre-boil gravity was 1037. Might be 1040, but it's not 1010. So we'll see how that ends up. If it's going to be good or not. It should be alright. I'm not that concerned about ABV and all that. So I'll go through the hops. I've got Curly, Tet 9, and Teletau Tradition in these.
Boom, boom, boom. Pearly, Pearly 2. Pearly, 60 minutes. Pearly 2, 15 minutes. Another Pearly 2 at 5 minutes. And then as well as Pearly and Tetney. That's the hop drop. And that's it, that's my dry hop round with this bad boy. Yeah. Fire's going. Check.
Hi Matthew.
Hi Dana.
What are you doing up?
Nothing.
Are you hungry?
No.
So what are you eating? What have you got? Grapes?
Yeah.
Yep. And you get some toast there as well. It's almost like a wee supper. Do you know who else would like food?
Yeah.
Would you like food?
Meow.
Yeah.
Yeah, love some food.
You loving the buffet? I've never seen you dance like that, Matthew, ever.
I know.
Ten bells.
We are chilling. Happy days. Chilling.
Whoop, whoop.
Oh, that was a bit of a battle. It's what, 25 past 10. So, get us chilled, get it in the fermenter, get it in the fridge, chill it at 10. Tomorrow morning, pitch. Need to tidy up now. Put on all this nonsense. The fun bit. And all this.
Ba 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 bam, she's in. Although I'm not so sure about the slide angle. Probably just gonna put the blow off on. She's tied up. She is on.
So, we are at 10 degrees.
Pitched in this morning. No activity as of yet. With no bubbles. But, it's early days yet.
Yo! Thought we'd come in there, have a look and see how this beer's doing. Should I say lager? I had to pump up the temp because it was taking forever. I think it was about 3 days. So, I've put it up to 12. See how she's doing. Is that a bubble? Yay! She's a bubbling. Oh, two bubbles. Good. I think we'll maybe chuck it down to 11 and keep it there now. See how that goes. Cheers, guys.
Lager's still bubbling away. 10.3 just now. Seems to be doing quite well. It's quite vigorous fermentation at the moment. Well, vigorous is in for a lager anyway, it's vigorous. It's quite happily bubbling away there. So, yep, this is the next day, by the way. So, aye. Happy dish.
How we doing? That's us now 2 weeks in, and I've started to do my diastole rest, so I'm just slowly increasing it every morning.
13.2 the now. I increased it last night, so I'm just going to put it up. Oh, that'll do.
And there she is, the Munich Helles, St Mungo's clone. She is ready. So there it is, my Munich Helles St Mungo's clone, ready for consumption. Turned out 4.8% ABV, which is about right. Oh, that's good. It's very, it's definitely got that kind of malty German character.
It's definitely got a kind of, it's like a kind of, I don't know, Munich malt kind of bubbliness. Notably bitter, goes down and just get a lovely deep flavour to it. That's good. Anyway, cheers, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.